Hello and welcome to Ignite 2022. My name is Chauncey Larson and I'm on the Surface Commercial Marketing team. And today you'll be hearing from IT pros and community MVPs on best practices for deploying and adopting Surface in your organization. Joining me today are MVPs Barb Bowman, Adam Ball, and Soonki Park. Barb Bowman has 25 years of experience in the field, having worked as a quality engineer and product development manager. Adam Ball is a Microsoft VIP and co-founder of Cloud Revolution and Comms VNext. And Soonki Park is joining us all the way from Korea, where he works as a digital strategy coach and is a Windows and Device for IT MVP. We're excited to have you today and really appreciate your expertise and willingness to share it with everyone. Together, we'll be discussing the value of using Surface as an enterprise customer, best practices for successful Surface implementation, and our MVP's favorite ways to be engaged with the Surface community. So, for my first question, I'd love to know how you feel Surface adds value and makes a positive impact for your customers. Adam, let's start with you.
Yeah, it's a great question. For our customers, when we start talking about the Surface Hub, it really comes down to that ability to collaborate quickly together, whether it's putting the hub in like an open area where people can just walk up and do impromptu meetings and start to whiteboard. It's just one of those fantastic spots. Or even if you want to put it in a meeting room where you might have an MTR based with the Surface Hub and do a coordinated meeting, people just really enjoy the experience with it. Being able to use that whiteboard in a meeting and then come back, you can really get your ideas out there really quickly and are able to take ideas further faster and being able to just move things along, which is really what we're trying to do when we get into meetings and especially hybrid meetings. We're just trying to move ideas forward.
Thanks, Adam. That's great. And I love your perspective on how Surface Hub can help customers take their ideas further, faster. Barb, given your experience, I would love your perspective on how you feel Surface adds value for your customers.
For tablet users, the Surface Pro line offers a premium Windows experience in a very portable package. This is great for knowledge workers, sometimes working in clamshell mode using a Surface Pro. It's lightweight, detachable, full-size mechanical keyboard with backlighting, and it's instantly detachable or convertible for those needing to take handwritten notes at meetings. Like all Surface devices, it's dock-friendly for an expanded multi-monitor workstation. Surface Pro has been described as a computer that changes to fit your needs as you go through the day, whether working from home, at the office, on the road, or even on a plane or train. Great screen quality equals no eye strain at the end of a long day. With both front and back cameras, and with some models with LTE connectivity, Pro is becoming the device of choice for many field-based workers, such as real estate agents, insurance appraisers, who need the flexibility to connect anywhere. Surface Pro allows them to visually document conditions in high-quality images and still have all the features of a powerful desktop in a grab-and-go device. For traditional clamshell laptop users, especially those who want a larger screen, the ultra-portable Surface laptop is a favorite of quite a few local schools, both for staff and students. Its lightweight and all-day battery life make this attractive for teachers and students who are on the move throughout the day. Using Microsoft-provided imaging tools such as the SDA, Surface Deployment Accelerator, IT can easily create images on USB sticks for deployment or recovery using a Windows 10 or 11 professional or enterprise ISO that can be used in the office or sent to a remote employee. Microsoft has redesigned the latest devices to offer more repairability than previous generations and has made comprehensive service guides available for download and offers a few videos as well. And while not needed often, IT admins love the ability to replace the SSD in the latest generation of Surface devices, Creative firms like landscape architects and advertising agency professionals are discovering the versatility of the Surface Laptop Studio as a powerful, portable design workstation with its unique ability to transform into an artist's tablet.
Yes, I love how adaptable the Surface devices are for so many people. No matter where people work or what type of work they do, there are Surface devices that can accommodate all their needs. All right, Soonki, what about you? How do you feel Surface has added value for your customers?
마이크로소프트 서피스 디바이스는 2020년부터 시작된 하이브리드 워킹 시대에 필요한 하드웨어, 애플리케이션 호환성, 신뢰성, 마이크로소프트 365와 결합된 칩 to 클라우드 보안, 지속적인 펌웨어와 드라이버 지원을 모두 제공하고 있습니다. 한국의 기업과 기업 중에 IT 역량이 많이 부족한 곳에서는 마이크로소프트 서피스를 선택함으로써 불필요한 고민 없이 업무에만 집중할 수 있는 영향을 주고 있습니다.
That's a great point, Soonki. That ability to help people focus on what's important is something we're really proud to be able to provide for our customers. With that, I would like to transition to my second question. What are some best practices for successful implementation of Surface? Barb, why don't you go first this time?
Out of the box, Surface for business devices with Windows Pro are instantly usable, and this is probably the option that will be used by most small businesses. For larger businesses and enterprise customers, there are a couple of options when there is a need to control access to built-in peripheral functionality. When enterprise IT needs to secure and protect devices, Microsoft offers cloud-based tools for newer Surface devices. The Device Firmware Configuration Interface, DFCI, is part of Microsoft Intune and can be used to access UEFI settings that control access to system components and peripherals. Alternatively, and for companies who have deployed older devices, such as Surface Book 1 and 2, Surface Pro X, Surface Pro 5 and 6, SEM, the Microsoft Surface Enterprise Management Mode, provides a certificate-based method to enroll devices and configure UEFI settings. If your organization ever has a hardware issue and needs a repair or replacement, the Microsoft Hardware Support Portal is built into the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. The portal also lets IT admins check warranty status and add new devices to an existing plan. You may not know that Microsoft offers on-demand webinars that encompass best practices and tips for Surface deployment. These Inspiration on Demand seminars, as Microsoft calls them, include topics like learn how to deploy the secure modern workplace anywhere. You can learn how a Microsoft Surface device powered by Microsoft 365 enables a simpler, automated, and unified approach to secure endpoint management, including zero-touch self-serve deployment, where you can remotely provision and deploy devices more easily and efficiently. And you can do this in minutes rather than days. You can keep employee devices updated, secure, and fully managed from the cloud.
It's our ease of deployment and innovation on cloud provisioning we feel set us apart. So I'm glad your customers are enjoying being able to take full advantage of them. Soonki, what do you consider to be some best practices for a successful implementation?
네, 굉장히 좋은 질문입니다. 한국의 비즈니스, 요 커머셜 영역의 대표적인 사례부터 소개를 드려야 될 것 같은데요. 마이크로소프트 고객 사례로 공개적으로 소개된 바 있는 국책은 한 곳, 그리고 사명을 좀 언급드리기 어려운 재보험사가 있습니다. 보수적인 IT 환경을 가진 금융권이지만요. 마이크로소프트 서피스 디바이스, 그리고 마이크로소프트 팀즈를 통해 공간과 시간의 관계없는 하이브리드 워크로 적응을 했습니다. 그리고 이들 기관은 윈도우스 오토파일럿과 마이크로소프트 엔드포인트 매니저를 통해 디바이스 관리와 칩 to 클라우드 보안을 적용하고 있는 공통점을 가지고 있는데요. 한국의 비영리, 비정부 영역에서도요. 이들 비즈니스 앤 커머셜 영역과 못지않은 모범 사례들이 존재를 합니다. 지역을 구체적으로 좀 언급드리기 어렵습니다만은 한국에서 가장 큰 지역의 사회복지사 사례를 그 우선으로 소개해 드립니다. 사회복지사 보수교육은요. 2020년부터 마이크로소프트 팀즈를 통한 비대면 교육으로 운영되고 있고요. 현재는 하이브리드 교육이 시범 운영 중입니다. 비대면과 하이브리드 교육을 진행하는 데 있어 서피스 랩탑 디바이스의 안정성, 그리고 신뢰성, 높은 주변 기기 호환성은 강사와 교육 담당자 모두를 만족시키고 있습니다. 그리고 경기도 성남시에 위치한 직업보호장 한 곳과 서울 서부 지역에 위치한 자활센터 사례를 마지막으로 소개를 드립니다. 성남시에 위치한 직업보호장은요, 중증장애인의 직업 제공, 그리고 직업 훈련을 통한 자립을 돕는 기관입니다. 두 곳의 카페와 배달 도시락 생산시설을 운영하고 있는데요. 자활센터는 서울 서부권의 저소득층의 자립을 돕는 기관으로서 직업교육, 그리고 편의점 운영, 그리고 카드배송 공익사업 위탁 운영에 자활 근로사업을 운영하고 있습니다. 이들 기관은 IT 역량은 부족합니다. 하지만 높은 수준의 하드웨어 보안, 그리고 지속적이고 통일된 관리 환경, 외부 업무에 맞는 디바이스가 필요했는데요. 거기다가 굉장히 오래된 데스크탑과 랩톱을 교체를 해야 되기 때문에 마이크로소프트 서피스 프로 제품을 대량으로 도입을 했습니다. 도입 후에 몇 번의 랜섬웨어와 멜웨어를 방어한 일이 있었고요. 그리고 디바이스 분실도 몇 번 있었습니다. 원격으로 디바이스 초기화를 진행해서 다른 사람이 데이터에 접근할 수 없도록 조치를 취했고요. 그리고 이 디바이스들은 조직 내 사용자 외에는 그 디바이스를 쓸 수 없기 때문에 그 운이 좋게도 광역철도 유실물센터에서 이 그 분실된 디바이스를 모두 회수할 수 있었습니다. 오늘 소개한 비영리 비정부 기관들은요. 비영리용 마이크로소프트 365 비즈니스 프리미엄, 그리고 마이크로소프트 365 엔터프라이즈 E3, E5 라이센스를 통해서 마이크로소프트 365와 더불어서 엔드포인트 매니저, 그리고 윈도우즈 오토파일럿 사전 프로비저닝 환경이 구축이 되어 있습니다. 비즈니스용 원드라이브와 마이크로소프트 팀즈를 통해 공간과 시간을 넘는 협업은 물론이고요. ID와 디바이스, 그리고 데이터에 대한 칩 투 클라우드 보안, 엔드포인트 매니저 안에 있는 서피스 매니지먼트 포탈을 통한 서피스 디바이스 모니터링, 그리고 워런티 관리 기능들을 경험하고 있습니다. 그래서 여러 가지 이 구체적인 사례에 대해서는요, 이 세션이 종료된 후에 저희 링크드인과 네이버 블로그를 통해서 확인할 수 있도록 하겠습니다.
Yes, the Surface Management Portal is always available to help and provide super useful insights. Adam, we'd love to hear your thoughts on best practices too.
Yeah, when I start thinking about how to successfully implement Surface Hub and best practices, I really come up with three distinct best practices. First, put the hub out where people can use it. Putting the hub out in an open area or in huddle spaces where people can quickly walk up and start utilizing it without having to reserve it, that's a critical piece, in my opinion, of making the hub successful in deployment. The second one is ensure that you have all the account settings correct. Very specifically, follow the guidelines that Microsoft provides, especially around the Exchange components, so that when you do reserve a room that has a Surface Hub in it, or you want to be able to join a Teams meeting, it can happen very quickly and easily. So getting the account settings correct. And then third is going to be make sure that you assign the right license to it. Make sure that you get a Microsoft Teams room license for it. Those second two, making sure we have the account set up correctly along with the right license, allows for everything to happen at the user level of that seamless ability to walk up, utilize the hub, and join meetings really easily and quickly. And so that's why those two are important.
Phenomenal tips, team. And I hope everyone picked up on something that will help them with their deployment. All right, last question. What are some ways IT pros and Surface enthusiasts can engage in the Surface community? Soon-ki, I will let you field this one first.
네, 오늘 세션에 대한 질문을 비롯해서요, 마이크로소프트 서피스, 그리고 마이크로소프트 365에 대한 이제 여러 가지 질문들이나 혹시 뭐 구체적으로 저한테 얘기하시고 싶으신 게 있으실 것 같습니다. 그렇다고 하면 이 자막으로 나가는 링크드인, 트위터, 그리고 제 블로그와 인플루언서, 그리고 서피스 사용자 그룹을 통해서 저에게 연락을 주시면요, 성심성의껏 답변을 드리도록 하겠습니다.
Those are great resources. Thank you so much, Soon-ki. What about you, Barb?
Two things I recommend. First, for anyone looking for great information, the Surface YouTube channel has everything from overview videos to repair instructions. With many videos having a million views or more, this is a great starting point. The Surface channel on Reddit is my second recommendation. It has many threads on troubleshooting and how do you type questions, and has an audience of enthusiasts, IT pros, individual users, and from time to time, Surface engineers do join in the conversations.
I know, I've definitely watched some of those videos before, and they're super helpful. Adam, what are your favorite ways to engage with the community?
When I think about community and the Surface Hub community specifically, I always like to tell people to not ignore the Microsoft Teams portion of it. So think about the fact that Hub and Teams are very tightly integrated together. And so looking at both the Surface Hub blogs as well as the Microsoft Teams blogs up on Microsoft Tech Communities is a great first spot. Going out into the community, though, there's also the ComsV Next conference. They put out a lot of content out onto their YouTube channel for ComsV Next. I put out content at cloudrenegade.us as well as up onto the YouTube channel for Cloud Renegade as well. And then last but not least is find a local user group. Really feel like local user groups around Teams really does a great job of getting people together and allowing people to communicate and figure out what they might be doing successfully together.
I want to extend a huge thank you to all of you for providing these incredible resources for all of us to better engage with our community and the experts we have around the world. Part of the reason I was so excited to start working with the MVP community is because of the impact that you three and your peers have on all of our customers and fans. It's truly an honor. I want to extend a massive thank you to each of you, Barb, Adam, and Soonki, for taking the time to speak with me today. We appreciate your insight as a Microsoft MVP and are lucky to have the chance to hear from you on how Surface impacts the work you do. And if you'd like to learn more about joining the MVP community, here's where you can find them. And finally, be sure to follow our Surface IT Pro blog and check out our other Surface resources. Thanks for joining us.